YouTube, what's up, and welcome back to my channel, Material Girls Channel. I'm Madeline, and today I want to give you a quick tutorial on how to take care of your half wig. I'll be using a model today, not myself. This is Reagan, and she wears the same hair that I have, the Alcheray half wig by, and it's Yasmin. This is a color one. Is this a color one? Okay, and the only difference between my hair and her hair is she doesn't know how to properly take care of her wig. And that's so important because, ladies, you don't want to have a wig that looks lifeless, dull, and old, and matted. That's a no-no, okay? So I'm going to show you how to take care of your wig to keep it looking fabulous for at least a good 2 to 3 months. Okay, first of all, every night when you take your wig off, it's so important that you give it a quick brush through. I use a paddle brush, and basically, I lay it on my bed, but we're in a different space right now, so I'm just going to show you how to just brush your wig out. All you have to do is hold the hair really tight so that you don't pull the hair off of the wig cap, and just brush through it, untangling like all of the tangles, and just to get the hair back in its original shape, you just want to brush it. See how the back gets really matted? And that's also because it's against your back. And if you have, even if you have a sew-in, if you are a true weave wearer, then you'll know that the back of your weave always gets tangled in the back. So you just want to brush it. And no, you're not going to harm the hair. Just brush the hair. Oh, girl, you got Okay. So once you have the hair tangle free, once you have the hair tangle free, then you can go with putting on the wig. And this is kind of just the same as my first video. On my first video, however, I left a lot of hair out in the front. And that's one thing that I don't even know why I did that, because y'all, I don't leave hardly any hair out naturally. And so this time, putting on this non-wig wig, you'll see I'm leaving out less hair, because you really don't want to leave a lot of hair out, because that just means you have to blend that much more hair. And then here's the complication. Take a hair tie at the bottom of the head, just secure the hair in a little bun. Okay, so now that you have your hair hanging out, secure the hair. Can you see a good look at how I'm doing this? Just clamp the hair, the comb right there. Hold it right there. Hold it right here. I don't want to pull it. Okay. You just want to secure it over your hair. Okay? So once it's secured and it's feeling tight and loose, now comes the blending part, the most important part. And because sometimes your natural hair doesn't necessarily match the texture, so I'm going to use Luster's Pink Original Oil Moisturizer Hair Lotion. You can use any kind of, you can use setting lotion for that matter. I actually use setting lotion. You just want something that's going to allow the hair, your natural hair, to blend with the real hair. Also, remember, you can't put heat on this wig because it's not clean and synthetic, but you can add the lotion and the moisturizer to the entire thing from the hair. I
that's in the building. Make your bed right, girl. Make your bed right. Make your bed right.
Spend it all on you, baby. My room is the G spot. Call me Mr.